remain blessed in Jesus' name. That's my wish for you and me this time, because I have a topic a long time ago. Looking around to the Church of Christ, I'm sure that I'm happy when I saw, you know, the Holy Spirit moving around the world, save people, and the information comes to me is like more Christians, more people from the world accept Jesus, and that is beautiful. But sometimes in the Church of Christ, there is a problem, and as leaders, as responsible people working for the Lord, we must fix some things. And in order Jesus to come back to take complete authority. What I mean? I mean that the gift that he gives us must work perfectly. The ministers that we are ordained by God, we must to be honest, sincerely, humble people, to know what we must to do, to be under the Spirit, to commit our life under the Spirit of God. And Jesus must to dominate our life in order to have successfully Christian life. Hallelujah. So, in the Old Testament, we know that the Ark of Covenant was part of the tabernacle. So Moses received an instruction to create this ark in order to be part of the tabernacle, and they do spiritual things, and they serve the tabernacle, the Aaron and his Levi people. But for some reason, God allowed to be in captivity the Ark of Covenant. And at the moment, King Saul was not interesting about that. Maybe he feels that was not ready. But King David, with Prophet Samuel, was in unity in the moment to bring back the Ark of Noah. Why was necessary today to come back into Jerusalem means the spiritual explanation that the Ark of Covenant has two natures, was from wood and from gold. Means today the message for us, for born again people, is this. Jesus has two natures, was the Son of David and the Son of God. Hallelujah. Now is a living Jesus. So he was born in Bethlehem 2000 years ago from Joseph and Maria, chosen vessels to bring these heavenly products in our life, to be a savior, to be a deliverer, to be a blessings provider. Hallelujah. To give us another word, eternal life forever. Actually, religion people doesn't understand that everything in the Old Testament God create, or some laws, you know, represent something today. Means that the Ark of Covenant was not, you know, in the New Testament, was not ready to be and exist in a religion churches as today, Christians of Orthodox or Catholics or some others. They receive the lifestyle of Old Testament and bring some equipment from the tabernacle of God and from the law of Moses, and to bring into the New Testament. Means that when Jesus started to establish the first apostolic church in the upper room with apostles, means something new started. And the ruler at the moment who guide them and cover them and help them was the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. In the Old Testament, the Ark of Covenant was a spiritual image about the future that is coming time, Israeli people, that I want to bring the real Ark of Covenant. His name is Jesus. Hallelujah. That is the explanation, but it's impossible. Only born again people, you know, can understand what is the law in the Old Testament the Lord did, and what is the meaning in the New Testament for us today. I saw here that King David put in his heart to bring from the captivity the Ark of Covenant, all right? Here I saw in my spirit that it's necessary Jesus to come back, you know, not exactly to Jerusalem, to come back in his church, to take every authority, to fix the gift, you know, the prophetic gift or other gifts, to give us anointing to more people, because the harvest of rape, but the labors are few. So the labors, we have a role to play in the New Testament, and it is necessary with our behavior to bring, you know, Jesus into his church, because he has already planned to do something amazing those days. Hallelujah. So that is the good news. But we must fix our behavior. We must fix our faith. We must learn, you know, how the Holy Spirit works in the church. We have work to do with Christ. Hallelujah. We are not under the Moses now. We are in the best covenant, will of grace. Hallelujah. So Jesus says also, I don't came to cancel, you know, the laws of Moses. I came to fulfill it. The only person who fulfilled it, all those about 3,000 laws, don't do that, do that, you know, and all of that. It's he fixed, and he was only the perfect heavenly person who came on the earth and fulfilled everything, hallelujah, in order you and me today to be free, hallelujah. So, the Ark of Covenant, in order to come to Jerusalem, was desire of David and from Samuel, and also the people, the Israeli people, was in agreement, and they think that it's time and necessary that the Ark of Covenant to come to Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Means Jesus must come in the church. Hallelujah. But in order, that is the problem at the moment, with Israeli people, okay? The way that the Ark of Covenant comes must be spiritual, and the leaders that we invite Jesus in our churches, we must, you know, learn how to bring Jesus. We must learn to approach God with beautiful words, you know, in order to be honest, okay? And not through the worldly, you know, ways that the nation did. The nation already, you know, can approach God because they don't have mediator. Hallelujah. In other words, they don't have Ark of Covenant in their life. So, Samuel, if you go to 1 Samuel 6:7, okay, that you will see that Israeli people don't have to mimic the way of other nations, what they do, hallelujah, and how to transport, you know, back the Ark of Covenant and they make mistake. Because the Bible says, you can see Numbers 4:15 and also Exodus 25:14, you will see that a priest must carry that covenant in order to come. Today, I feel it that more anointing people is coming, but those people, they can carry the name of the Lord and they can, you know, explain the world about Jesus, to ministry his name and to do and to use exactly the gifts of the Holy Ghost today in the church, because over there it's coming to my attention that there is a lot of mistake. An example, not all priests, preachers, ministers who involved with the name of the Lord is ordained by God. Not all of them appointed by God in his church to do spiritual job. Not the gifts, all the gifts working perfectly. I'm talking about prophetic voice, visions and all of that. Sometimes flesh comes into the spirit realm and affect, you know, the way of the gifts. The gifts comes from the Holy Ghost. Everyone has gift today, but not everyone knows how to use his gift. We need time to learn. We need time to spend time with the Holy Ghost in order to be, you know, perfect people. As Jesus says to Abraham, walk with me and be perfect. Perfectly is the way of the Lord. Infallibility also we must to be. Hallelujah. So, finally, okay, the Ark of Covenant has to be upon the yoke of the priests, included today. The anointing must to carry real anointing people to preach the word with signs, wonders, and miracles, okay? And then salvation works better, healing works better, deliverance works better. At the moment, we saw that when King David, you know, returned back the Ark of Covenant into Jerusalem, it happened something. He was very upset and very sorrowful because some of them was next to the ark, and the ark was, you know, the oxes, you know, moving with the Ark of Covenant, and a little moving, you know, a little, you can see around 13 chapter 9 and 10 and 11, that one of them who take care of the tabernacle not to fall down because of the fear, the burden was holy burden upon the place that they walk the oxes. And he tried to touch, but for some reason he passed away. Actually, you can ask me why Hosea, you know, passed away at the moment. And what happened? Some people, they don't understand that. It's not the problem of Hosea. The problem, see the phenomenon that shaked, you know, a little the Ark of Covenant and tried to touch her and pass away. Actually, we must be careful when we involve ourselves with spiritual stuff, because the Holy Spirit is very sensitive and doesn't allow some things in his church. As an example, in the upper room was two people, Ananias and Sapphira, who they lies, but because of the presence of the Holy Ghost upon Peter, they pass away. Today, I never saw, because many Christians lie. This is truth sometimes, okay? But nobody else pass away because it's not so strong presence upon the leaders. Peter was an anointed man, and he shadow brings different into the life of others, healing and all of that. So Uzzah passed away, you know, at the moment, and David was very sorrowful, but the explanation is that that the man was not wrong. Wrong was the way that of the David. King David brings, you know, the Ark of Covenant, you know, the same style like the nations did. And I tells you, when we use, you know, activities or words from religion in order to bring Jesus, Jesus never is going to be comfortable. Hallelujah. So King David must to see what the Word of God says, okay? What the Word of God says, and you don't have to copy what the nations did. Means that Levi, you know, priests of Aaron, must to carry the Ark of Covenant back. Means we have a role to play. Hallelujah. I realize at the moment that King David and all of them and Israel, they have zeal, but they don't have a good methods to bring back the Ark of Covenant. Means today also, we don't have so much spiritual. We are not instructed, you know, directly from God what must I go to do. And also in our churches, sometimes we don't do things spiritually. Oh, sometimes we say, never mind, it's okay, God has mercy and all of that. But I will tell you, when you carry the Word of God, you must to see. In any case, in any situation you find yourself in, you must to see how to handle the problem. Not what you think, not what others says about the solution. It is about the Word of God. We must to know perfectly the Word of God, in order, you know, to do things biblically. Hallelujah. Because I know that all of us, we have problems, we have questions. Where do we go to ask? You know, some other from the past or some others who had some experience. All these good things. But when you carry the Word of God, hallelujah, and you must to know exactly where is the place about the situation. King David doesn't did that. Hallelujah. She don't use the biblical way to bring the Ark of Covenant. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we don't have to do copy about what the others did. Romans 15 chapter, verse 4, Apostle Paul says that all these things written, you know, for us today, in order, you know, sometimes, yes, we are in the law, but there is explanation in the spirit for us today. What is the message? The message is that we need Jesus more than anything else. We need Jesus to come to take it complete authority upon our life. We need Jesus to establish real anointing people in his church. We need to learn how to handle the Holy Bible and how to use those who is in need. A lot of people suffer today, my people. A lot of people, you know, has problems. A lot of people looking for solution. Many sickness or many demons. People their life affected by demonic influences, generation curses, and so all of that. We must to understand that only Jesus is a solver problem, and only Jesus can guide us directly through the Holy Ghost into the successful life. Hallelujah. So, and 2 Samuel 6:17, that the Bible says that the Ark of Covenant must to be in the right place. Not to hospitality in another place, not hospitality out of the will of God or in aliens' hand, but must to be in the right place. And the right place is the Church of Christ. The Church of Christ is the best place, you know, to Jesus to be comfortable inside. We are His church, okay? We have a role to play those days. If we don't know, you know, how to be a warrior against the army of darkness, who already there are opposites us. Hallelujah. So, it was beautiful between David and Samuel, and the people was all in agreement. Today, we must to be in that level, like one Christ, one God, one Holy Spirit, one faith, one church. Out of that, all others today, I don't think so that the Holy Spirit is so comfortable when he saw that churches, denomination, you know, Tambela, different names and all of that. And without unity, without respect, sometimes each one another, sometimes, you know, leaders with, they don't know exactly what is their call. They are not sometimes sure that the gift that they have, you know, works perfectly, or their ministry, it's from above. Hallelujah. Any Christ leader must be sure that, yes, I am in Christ. Yes, I received that call from the Lord. And yes, I know how to handle my call in order the Lord, you know, to receive. And when you know that you receive it, that call, you know how to handle, and harvest is going to come in their churches. Those people who carry anointing, the anointing shall be broke, the yoke of bondage, but the anointing likes to use his people in the church. Hallelujah. I saw through my experience, you know, with my apostolic call, I saw today that there is a problem, okay? The religion, traditions, dwelling in the Church of Christ sometimes, you know, and the words sometimes of those people, you know, cover the wisdom of God and the knowledge of God that we must to have. Hallelujah. So the revelation of the Lord, we can cover, you know, with our opinion, the revelation of the Lord. Hallelujah. Ignorance is not the ally, okay? Or any dark area or ignorance must move from the Church of Christ. That is a part of my message. Hallelujah. I don't know that. I don't know how to do that. You must know in order to have, you know, in your hand a ministry from above. You must learn, you must spend time with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. So, not Church of Christ, not supposed to be under the shadow of darkness, and dark stuff must to be in the Church of Christ. Hallelujah. Huh. Sometimes, you know, people see that the gifts work in the church, and that is truth. Because Romans 11:29 says that gifts cast from above, but Jesus doesn't take it back. Doesn't mean that one church is perfect, because some gifts, some prophetic voices, some advices, some counseling, you know, the gifts work. Hallelujah. We need, people of God, the presence of God, not only His hand. Hallelujah. Remember, in the book of Exodus, 33 chapter, verse 15, Moses has a conversation with God, and the Lord revealed him that you are chosen vessel to deliver my people from Egypt. Hallelujah. But Moses expressed his heart and said something true. Oh, my Lord, I can't talk. I can't speak perfectly, you know, how to go to transfer your words to those people in Egypt. He said, okay, don't worry. I'm going to give you Aaron, your brother. Go with him. Yes, but he says, you know, that what else I have to prove them that I am a messenger of you? He says, you have your road, okay? Use your road. Hallelujah. And Moses was a little, you know, was a humble man, actually, and speak, you know, with respectfully to God, but says to the Lord, I don't need, you know, your hand. I need your presence. And in the end, Jesus sometimes, you know, likes conversation with him, you know, when we use the word of God, when we say to him, you know, truth things. He likes to have conversation with us. He likes to answer us some opinion, hallelujah. In order to receive and to fulfill our call, we need, you know, connection with the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit always are available to teach us, to show us, you know, how to do that, how to walk, okay, and all of that. So Moses, you know, invoke his presence until the Lord tell him, I shall be with you. And we know that he used him miraculous, tremendous miraculous, you know, front of the Red Sea, how beautiful he touched with the road, you know, the sea, and some million of people, you know, and pass through the Red Sea, and also front of the Pharaoh. He used, you know, the authority of God to show to the Pharaoh and to tell the Pharaoh that, let my people, leave my people to come to worship me. Hallelujah. And he got big victory. Hallelujah. So we need to tell the Lord, hallelujah, not enough, Lord, that we have gift. Thank you. You give us a gift from above. Thank you. But we need your presence in our life. And when the presence comes, and that makes the difference in our church, hallelujah. Sometimes, you know, it happened to my past that when we start worship Jesus by His Spirit, anointed songs, I feel His presence on my face. When I start sometimes ministry and my heart is in right position, and the spirit of my spirit is humble, I feel, you know, the Holy Ghost moving into deliverance the people. Sometimes with the word of God, when I know what I say, because if we are a real ministers, we must say what we say, but biblically to know the word of God. We can say, we can be in the pulpit to say, that's my opinion. That's I know. Or I'm not sure. If you say I'm not sure, you proclaim your weakness. Your weaknesses, you know. You can say that, you know, to show to the people that you are a weak vessel like them. We must have His presence upon our life in order to minister the hearts of the people. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you something. It comes to my attention that the Bible says, the Apostle Peter says, that all the prophetic voices, in the Old Testament and in the New Testament, you know, all fulfilled. And some of them, they still, you know, they still remain in the level to fulfill it, because everybody, every word of God was infallible. Every prophetic voice, you know, touches the heart of the people and fulfill it. But today, it comes to my attention that not all prophetic voices or dreams or the gifts works by the Spirit of God. Some, I saw that it's some a little flesh, some a little personal opinion. Some say things that, oh, what I say, it comes from the Holy Ghost. No, we must sure what I say in order the gift of God, okay? We must be infallible. Hallelujah. And if you see that different today, I think we must to fix that. I saw in the Church of Christ sometimes like four different fleshly things, I think, okay? I show first compromise spirit works among the church. Hallelujah. You can minister the word of God if something is contrary with the word of God. We must be infallible people, to have infallibility inside it. Hallelujah. I remember that years back, I go to some state in USA close to North Dakota. And really, the hospitality of people with beautiful Bible study, prayers, results, testimony, and I was really happy. But in the last day, we are in the Bible study in a big house and people around me, and the word of knowledge came to me that to say to some woman that the person that you live is marriage person and has no divorce yet, and you must to separate himself or to fix that mess in your life. And she had some relatives around, and I saw that suddenly his face changed, and the other relatives, you know, was a little aggressive behavior, you know, with me. I said to them, what's wrong with me? The Holy Spirit told me that, you know, she can't live in the same house with this man because he's a married man. He has to fix his past first, and then after, you know, through the Holy Ghost can do a new life, or if we allow, if it's biblical. And what happened? I was crying. They pushed me out of the environment, and I was in the airport. In the airport, 4 o'clock in the morning, I was very freeze this area. Too much snow, waiting 2 hours out of the door until the doors open to go inside to drink some tea. And I asked the Lord, and I say, Lord, you know, what happened? You tell me to say the truth. And the Lord revealed me very, very clearly in my spirit that you're right, John, but I tell you, when you say truth, you know, sometimes people doesn't accept the truth. And in order to be true ministers, you must to be infallible. What you say. So, and I know now after years experience, you know, that when you serve the Lord and if you are infallibility, never you can be a popular person to applaud you every time, hallelujah. Like Jesus. Jesus has his people who believe in him and follow him until the end. But religion was against him, and also some others who one day they say, Hosanna, Hosanna, the son of David, and the next day they put him on the cross of Calvary and looking for Barabbas to be free, the crime man. Yeah, you understand me? But it's cost a Church of Christ to be infallible those days. It's cost every minister who wants to preach the gospel with signs and wonders to be a true minister. We shall be under persecution. I saw Christians persecuted at the moment because they don't want Jesus, they don't want the Bible, and they don't want the word Christianity. But Jesus says those days, the last days, the gospel shall be preached all over the world, and after shall become the end, all right? So compromise is the first spirit that is against, you know, the Church of Christ. Number two is worthless spirit, okay? A spirit of the world is inside. We can be Sunday Christians. All the week we must be the same, holy people, because God is a holy God. Hallelujah. And then religion is in the church. Sometimes preachers doesn't learn through the anointing some things in the school of Christ, okay, involved with the Holy Ghost. They have some traditions from the grandparents, and they follow the human opinion in the church. And that is religion, because traditions cancel it, actually, the word of God. You can follow traditions and the truth. Remember that Pharisees went to Jesus and says to him, you know, why your disciples doesn't clean the hand that the law says, okay? But Jesus, you know, tell them the truth. It's not bothers, you know, what we eat, what comes inside. What outside comes from our mother, that bothers us. Means, you know, most of our problems are tongues problems. And when we must be careful what you say. Look at the life of Jesus. Every time that Jesus answers something, you know, the word that he comes out of his mouth glorify the name of the Lord. Actually, he used the words of the Holy Bible. Hallelujah. So we must follow the lifestyle of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And then there is also number four problem is the fake unity. Sometimes we love one another, but anything, if something happened, you know, our relationship broken quickly and words come out of our mouth. I don't want that person. Yes, I know sometimes things bothers us. But we must learn the silence, never misunderstand. We must learn, you know, what the Bible says. If you see your brother, you know, has any problem, you have to pray, and the Lord is going to bring solution. Hallelujah. Our love inside in our heart must be in the high level in order, you know, to see the hand of God upon their life. Those four, today, those four, you know, spirits, I saw through my experience that comes in the church. And also, there are three big demonic influence against the churches, that one is Judas. Judas, is the spirit of Judas, actually, attacked the Church of Christ, everything about money. That's because there is a part of the leaders who they receive gift for me is my brother in Christ. But their behavior return and they live very luxury life. They have a big prosperity, and the prosperity that the Lord gives them is not to be in the bank, you know, to receive interest and all of that, and to have all this, you know, beautiful stuff. Because Jesus and apostles was an example of theirs 2,000 years ago. Jesus, the Bible says that he don't have a pillow where he has to put his head. Hallelujah. Stone he puts. Today, you know, we have luxury life. Why? This is because of the spirit of Judas, always everything about money. Hallelujah. The prosperity has to come. If If money comes in the church, the prosperity as leader, I must learn how to come into the people, those who is in need. If I am a rich minister of the gospel, must to be richness into the people, to see what they need to be, to cover them, to help them, hallelujah, to give them abundantly. And that spirit must to move out. I don't think so, that those who carry that spirit of Judas and looking for and has a lot of money, in the end shall be in problem. Jesus knows. Okay. Number two is the spirit of Delilah. Delilah, you know, was the woman who Samson married her, but she showed that Samson was a very strong and anointed man. She doesn't know that the power was in the Old Testament in his hair. In the New Testament, of course, you know, the Bible says, Apostle Paul says, that men who carry long hair is abomination, is no good. This doesn't lie. A woman has to have long hair, if that is impossible, okay? So, Samson was an anointing man, but manipulate his life, you know, every night, Samson makes a mistake and reveal what is the spring of his power, all right? And we see that his life become, you know, goes through wilderness, trials, tribulation, you know, they arrest him and they criticize him and all of that. In the end, when his hair, after all those trials, getting long, the power come back, and he say, I'm passing away now with those people, 3,000 and more people. When he shake the column of the temple, you know, they fell down and pass away with them. Of course, Samson goes to the, got the last victory and goes to heaven, but all those people who they damage his life, they damage his eyes, you know, pass away, and I don't think so, they go to heaven. So that spirit of Delilah looking against the anointing people to manipulate them, another word, flesh, comes. That's because many of Christians, leaders fell today, commit adultery or fornicate because of the temptation. The most important, through my experience, people of God, when you go to serve the Lord, alleluia, it's necessary before you must to rebuke that spirit and to not to be tempted. Temptation and ministry together, they don't match, they don't go together. Temptation, you know, we must to crucify ourselves into the cross if we want successful life. So the spirit of Delilah works to destroy anointing people of God. Hallelujah. And they really exist. I have so many experiences around the world, and I'm not happy about that. The number three is the Jezebel, a woman who in her table, you know, eats, they have food, all those witchcraft and people of Baal, and Jezebel used them as instrument for results until Elisha comes with power and strong anointing and destroy all of them in one day. Miraculous event, it happened. You can read that. So this kind of spirit attacked the Church of Christ. We must stand to know, hallelujah, how to rebuke that kind of spirit, how to go out of that spirit, hallelujah. Only Holy Spirit can get victory against that, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jeremiah says that because of this worldly worldly mannerism there are in the church. God revealed to Jeremiah to chapter 5, verse 30 and 31, you can read it, that God says to Jeremiah, my son, they like that, people. I remember something, sometimes they like false things. Maybe some of them, they know that what is the false, but they like, because in their ear, it's likes to hear that, hallelujah. 25 years ago, I have a little meeting, you know, my first church in Long Island, New York, and I have a visitor with a Greek American background, and he came many times, and he saw that sometimes the Lord using me to give prophetic voice, but I never have something to give him, like prophetic voice. And one day he say, Brother John, sometimes you speak to many people, but I love prophecy, you know. Can you tell me some prophecy? And I don't care if it's real or not. I say to him, listen, I must say what the Lord put me words in my mouth. I can't say from my heart things to please you or to make you happy. Hallelujah. And this is not good when you don't care about if it's truth or, but you want prophecy, you love prophecy. Sometimes people go to the church to listen some good things. And when the preaching is good, you know, oh, that is for me. They says, but it is good, you know, the word of God to run around the heart, from brain to brain and all of that. It is good when the people are happy through the message. But sometimes, you know, when we don't have, you know, good mannerism in God's presence and our behavior is no good, we need correction. When I was a young guy, always I pray and say, Lord, I'm going to the church. If you see something wrong in me, correct me, I don't care. I humble myself, you know, that's my way, you know. The Lord give me that kind of spirit to realize sometimes that I'm not a perfect person, I make mistake. And Jesus likes when his people realize that they need correction. Correction with the Holy Ghost is medicine in our spirit to fix our life, to learn, you know, what we must do next. Always, you know, anyone who realizes that something wrong in his life and repent and confess, Jesus is going to heal them. He loves us amazing. He cares for us to be spiritual saved and physical healed. If he likes that, you know, why I have to reject this heavenly impactation in my life? Hallelujah. So, because those kind of prophetic voices, you know, they give a little relief sometimes in the church, but not real. We need a real presence in our life, you know, to put things in order in our life, to start for our personal efforts, okay? Everyone who serves the Lord must know what hospitality in his heart. Hallelujah. What is the negative things? Another thing, the next step, we must fix our environment. Not only to be anointed and powerful people, we must to teach our children, our wife, to be in unity, in harmony, to live, to have, you know, to walk together. Hallelujah. Behind Jesus, through the narrow gate, as I say sometimes. Then after, you know, to bring a revival in his environment, the business supposed to be good business, you know. And the spirit of Jesus doesn't have problem to give you prosperity, but he must teach you and me before to learn to receive, we must learn to give. That's because years back, when I was a young guy, I have financial problem, really. And I says to the Lord, you know, why you don't give me, you know, a lotto with five numbers, you know, to in order to have, I'm not a beggar. But the Lord answered me in a dream and say, if I give you now money, I will lose you, John. I must teach you first to give. And it happened. One period of my life, I learned. He tells me, you know, stinginess is not from the Lord. Okay? And I learned something. Whatever comes out of my right pocket, I receive from the left pocket. Okay? Means we must learn that people need us. We must learn, you know, to help others, those who is in need today. And then we must to bring relief into the heart of the people. Hallelujah. But sometimes it comes to my attention, people of God, and I have a notice here, okay, that we covered today our sins to protect our reputation. Means sometimes, you know, we have some kind of behavior to block the truth to come outside. King David, front of the Ark of Covenant, he danced very happy because the Ark returned to Jerusalem. But his wife, Saul's wife, you know, criticized him and say, oh, why you do that, you know, like front of the, you are king, you know, you don't have to do that. He say, front of the face of the Lord, I humble myself, you know. And he dancing, you know. But you see, always demons are opposite you, to critical, to criticize you, to demote your energy, to block you, to make you disappointment, failure, and all of that, you know. Don't worry, you must know that Jesus is in your cover. When Jesus is in your cover, you know, we must learn how to be rejoicing for the Lord and not to cover ourselves. What is the big deal if somebody knows my problem? Maybe if he's a good person, he's gonna pray for me. If he's a bad person, he has problem with the Lord. Hallelujah. Because, you know, I am in God's presence. You are in God's presence, and all of us, you know, we are in God's presence. Hallelujah. So praise the Lord for those words that I said today, because I saw in my spirit that we must to fix things in order to invite Jesus in our environment, in our church. Hallelujah. Not only his hand, but his presence to come. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that Jesus is going to return. In the book of Jeremiah says, you go at the moment and you sound to me and you will find me when you invoke with real heart, with real spirit. You understand me? Jesus has a character. And if we know as Christians how to touch the character and the heart of Jesus Christ, actually, he is going to come in our life. I know sometimes the Holy Ghost waiting opposite and sometimes getting disappointment on our behavior, but I'm going to tell you something. When we return and we think, oh, we must to bring back his presence in our life, always the Holy Ghost is there to fix your life. He likes to fix, to restore. He's a God of restoration, of reconciliation. I don't know what is your problem. Maybe you have a family problem. Maybe you have fight with your wife. Maybe you have some other problems with relatives. Maybe you have inheritance problems and you fight. Maybe, you know, you have some issues that the others talk to you, talk for you against you and criticize you and critical and all of that. I'm gonna tell you something. Do not be afraid what others, you know, doesn't against you. I will tell you something. You must know that Jesus loves you. And Jesus, you know, doesn't call you by accident. Your chosen vessel, you know, to walk with him. Your chosen vessel to hear his glory in your life. Your chosen vessel to be, you know, in heaven with him one day. In order all these things, you know, we must increase our faith to be stable. Not one day in the water, another day in the earth. Hallelujah. No, we must stay stable under the Holy Bible. Carry the Holy Bible as the best instrument of results. Hallelujah. And if you feel that you need Jesus in your heart, means pray. Jesus is going to return powerfully with no negative words for you, because he never reminds when any person of us, sister or brother in Christ, return and confess. Jesus never rejects any prayers when comes through the contracting heart. Hallelujah. Jesus wants to dwell in you, my brother and my sister, to your heart. No, as a visitor, sometimes comes and sometimes don't come, sometimes no visitor, no rental man. He has to feel that your heart is his house and can come with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost to dwell in you. Hallelujah. So beautiful. And then when he comes in your heart, amendments happen. Everything is going to change. Hallelujah. It's time the Church of Christ to receive back Jesus. It's time, you know, the Jewish people to receive the tabernacle, the Ark of Covenant, you know, in order, you know, to build their future. We know that about that things. Hallelujah. It's sometimes things from the past. It's for us very, very timely for us. Hallelujah. I saw in my spirit that Jesus wants to express himself. And I visit one day one brother in Christ, and he tells me in a beautiful dream. I ask him, what is your dream? And he said, John, I saw in my dream that Jesus was on wheelchair, disability to walk, and walk, you know, with that wheelchair, you know, unable to move himself, and ask him, my Lord, you are on the wheelchair? And Jesus says to him, yes, my son, I am like this because my members, my people, doesn't listen to me, doesn't obey to me, doesn't do things, you know, from above. That's because I feel like this. Of course, Jesus is not a disability, don't live in the wheelchair, but he speaks sometimes through parables. Sometimes he speaks through circumstances. Sometimes he speaks through images to us. Hallelujah. So we must learn, okay, that Jesus, he must dwell in our heart powerfully, to be comfortable with our behavior. And if you feel that anything negative, it's time to fix that. Take it word in your mouth and go and approach him. And Jesus is going to give you grace. We are in the wheel of grace right now. Okay? And if we live in the wheel of grace, favor and mercy never missing in our life. Hallelujah. It's not matter, people of God, how much big is your problem. Okay? Jesus is solving problem. And I tell you from my experience, he likes to fix big mistake, big things. Hallelujah. Generation of vipers shall be the seed of the next church. You will see in all over the world big sinners to confess, to repent, and come. With people with witchcraft and so many negative, you know, demonic influence shall be returned to the Lord. They give the heart to the Lord. Hallelujah. And Jesus is going to hug them and to tell them, you are my son, you are my daughter. Hallelujah. So praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you want a little help for me, I can pray for you and you can pray with me. Hallelujah. Lift your hand, believing that you are in God's presence, believing, you know, that that the Holy Ghost has ear and eyes to see you. Hallelujah. To correct, you know, mistakes from the past. Hallelujah. You need a new dawn. You need a new life. You need your smile back. You know, prayers makes the difference in our life. Prayers with open heart. We don't have to use word to impress Jesus. Jesus never impressed. Jesus, you know, sees your heart. If your heart and my heart is connected with contracting heart, results come in our life. So praise the Lord. Pray and say, Lord, I'm come to you in your presence. Hallelujah. Believing in your power, your resurrection power from the cross of Calvary, Lord. Hallelujah. I want to touch by faith your garments, Lord, right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. I want power, Lord. Son of David, have mercy on me. Send your anointing and your power and fix any department of my life, Lord. Hallelujah. Anything that around you that's not perfect, Lord, you can make me a perfect person. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, that I am your son. I am your daughter. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Divine healing in my spirit, Lord. Divine healing in my body. Whatever you are, ask the Lord. He's going to give you. He loves you amazing. He did that on the cross of Calvary 2,000 years ago. He lost all his precious blood. Just for you, hallelujah, for me and you, hallelujah. Touch his garment with his anointing, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Express any negative things, you know, that it's happened to you. Tell the Lord what you need, actually, hallelujah. What you need. You need a job. He likes to give you a new job. He likes to bring you in another and another level of prosperity. He likes to increase your smartness, your wisdom, hallelujah, in order to be useful instrument in God's hand, hallelujah. Thus, we must humble ourselves, hallelujah. Without Jesus, we can't do nothing. Without Jesus, we can't go nowhere, hallelujah. So praise the Lord, and your request shall become, hallelujah. We must learn when we use the right words, when our heart is in a level of humbleness, hallelujah, that heart Jesus never rejects, hallelujah. So praise the Lord. Tell the Lord, thank you, Lord, that you listen to me. Thank you, Lord, for your love. Thank you, Lord, that you cares for me, hallelujah, in my problems. Support my life. Build a new faith in my heart. Hallelujah. Touch the anointing, Lord. Touch my hand, my right hand, to pray upon people. Hallelujah. Touch, Lord, my lips to know how to speak the word of God with an effective spirit, Lord, full of results in my life. Thank you, Jesus. Use my eyes, Lord, to see visions of heaven, hallelujah, about me and my future and my family and my work, hallelujah. Use my ear, Lord, touch your ear and say, Lord, use my ear to listen your word, hallelujah. Yes, Jesus has word to give you. Jesus has vision. Jesus has dream to give you to fulfill the purpose of your life. Oh, to fulfill the purpose of your destination. You have a call. You are a gifted person. Hallelujah. In Christ Jesus. Learn how to use that gift that he gives you before the foundation of the world. And and receive, you know, this word that says to Abraham, walk before me and be perfect. Hallelujah. And you shall be perfect. We are not perfect at the moment, but when Jesus is involved in our life, hallelujah, beautiful things is going to happen. I believe that me and you now, we are blessed. We are people of future. We have future in Christ. We have role to play. Hallelujah. And when we have role to play through Jesus, he's going to give us victory. Remember, people of God, Christ's victory on the cross of Calvary is your victory. Believe it. Believe it and shall become to you. Amen. Thank you. The Jewish people says, Baruch haba Hashem Adonai. Blessed who comes in the name of the Lord. Eh? And the person who is going to come in the name of the Lord is Jesus. That we need at the moment. Through his spirit to come, to impact our life, and to remove everything that's not from the Lord. Hallelujah. Darkness must be defeated in Jesus' name. I bless you. You are blessed in Christ Jesus.